This is an experiment. I've not actually tried this one before, so I'm really pleased it's working quite well. This is just an aluminium bar, and we've got a hammer connected into a simple circuit with a 1.5 volt cell, and that's connected via the kind of audio input into the computer, so we're using Audacity as a kind of oscilloscope again. Essentially, when Adam taps one end of the rod,
Adam, that's your cue,
then that hammer is going to be in contact with that rod for as long as it takes a wave. That hammer is going to be in contact with the rod for as long as it takes a longitudinal wave to travel along the rod and back again. So we're actually going to measure the wave speed by looking at the time at which it's in contact with the rod. The pulse, in other words, when it returns, is going to push the hammer off. And we're surprised actually how well this is working on our graph on Audacity. So this is the length of that tap, if you like. This is the length at which the hammer is in contact with the steel rod. You can see that you're only getting a voltage here during this contact time here. So we're using the project rate, which is like how many samples per second it does to get a time. So we can just read off the starting sample, the final sample, do the difference between that, and multiply it by the time between each sample, if you like. The project rate is 384,000 samples per second. So if we just take the number of samples and times it by 1 over 384,000, that gives us the time the hammer's in contact with the rod. And the time roughly is, the length of the bar was 0.765 meters. The time from our graph there was 3.15 times 10 to minus 4 seconds. And well, the speed therefore is 2 times that distance, because the wave's gone there and back. Divide that by the time gives you a wave speed of 4,860 meters per second, which is not bad. The calculated speed is about 5,000 meters per second. So we're quite close. So this is just some algebra to get us from Young modulus basically to an equation for speed in a solid, and then we've used that equation and the density of steel and aluminium and the Young modulus of steel and aluminium to work out their wave speed as it should be. And then this is our measured values over 5 repeats. We've got really close to the wave speed for steel, so that's worked out really accurately, but quite far away from the wave speed for aluminium. We think that might be because, well, most aluminiums are actually alloys, they're not pure aluminium, whereas this almost certainly will be mild steel. So we've got just about 1% difference there for the mild steel, but we're quite considerably about 12-13% off for aluminium. We did do a couple of evaluative things. So we did repeats because we were getting above and below, and we also tried like softer taps and harder taps. I'm not really sure if there's much we could else have done. We did have a really, really precise measurement for time. I guess there are some other uncertainties in there, but I think all in all it's pretty successful, and I think maybe if we knew a bit more about the actual aluminium that we had, we might have been a bit closer for this one as well.
Other free software is available? No, I don't know of any other free software that...
for free as well.
Why would you give it away?
I mean, it's... Yeah, exactly.